النهارده هكلمكم عن الكوردينيت ديسلوكيشن
اوف ذا خلاص انا شغال
فور فور مانجمنت اوف بيس.
بعد كده تقريبا لما يجيب فاضل يجيبه قبلها بشويه عشان ده هو كان هيفتح المحاضره انا كنت لسه بس انا ما
فتحهاش وانا بحكي مين اللي في البوزيشن اوف نير الانترفيو. The rare condition compared is one in 100,000, it's more common in Europe, but it's a third of the paralytic conditions like spinal vision. Tibia is always subluxated anterior with a posterior temporal contact spread posterior, and there is obviously valgus deformity of the knee that develops as the child grows older. Structures are affected, including the quadriceps, by erosion and contracture. The anterior capsule is contracted, the suprapatellar pouch is absent, the intertibial band is needed and anterior added to the deformity, the patella is underdeveloped, the cruciate seam may be absent, and the ossification of the knee if the disease is delayed. It is associated with the hip dislocation in half of the cases and the clutch region 30% of the cases.
خلاص
هي هو فايل كبير صح؟ انا بقول لحضرتك فايل كبير حوالي 400 متر صح؟ from the pathology we mentioned on the previous slide, we can understand that unfreed CDK will result in stiff and unstable knees. And actually, treated CDKs will never result in normal knees. We have limited goals, such as achieving a normal alignment as much as possible and a relatively functional range of motion. Our treatment options include conservative treatment like serial casting, percutaneous quadriceps dissection, and what is known as EY quadriceps plastic. Compared to the percutaneous recession of the quadriceps, the BYQ is at number one, associated with increased morbidity. There are a lot of adhesions. There's a lot of wound breakdown post-operative, and we have to anticipate this and tell the parents in advance. Sometimes we have to do up to three or four times change of cuffs and dressing under anesthesia until the wound closes and heals. There's a lot of blood loss because we cannot operate under full decay. But it is more successful in achieving and maintaining reduction in severe resistant cases. The BY quadriceps plasty, as a yet for Felix, was described back in 1922 and modified by Curtis and Fisher in 1969, in which the long anterior incision starts superomedial in the other thigh and ends lateral to the tibial tubercle. We do a long, we need a long inverted knee in the quadriceps, we do medium and after long in the parapatellar incision to mobilize the quadriceps extension. Try as much as possible to release the fibrosed quadriceps and patella from the underlying bone. The anterior capsule is divided transversely. The tibial band, which is a major deforming force, is divided. The knee is of the quadriceps is repaired in a Y pattern in 50 degrees of flexion, as summarized in this illustration. And with this intraoperative photo of one of our patients. The percutaneous recession. More later in 1989, sometimes a slight indentation in the Achilles tendon that we are all familiar with. We do a stab incision times two patellar lengths above the patella. We divide the fascia and the superficial part of the rectus femoris, and then we do two stab incisions, medial and lateral, above the patella to divide the retinaculi, taking some care when we attack the medial part because of the vessels, and then finally we need to hear a popping sound. In which the quadriceps is lengthened in continuity. We all know that the key, the knee is the key, as we say, so any hip or foot
movement. أنا دلوقتي لو اشتريت رسيفر مثلا للسبلات، الراجل هشام كان قال لي على الرسيفر اللي هو
تمام هشام بيقول The above knee cast is usually applied in a modified fashion, which is illustrated in this diagram, because we don't want to put a lot of cast in the medial fossa, otherwise we cannot achieve flexion of the knee. So we use a lot of slabs that are wrapped around the knee from anterior to posterior to try to achieve the medial fossa. The aim of the study that we conducted was to introduce a new classification that could fully linked with the severity of the condition and allow a treatment protocol to be set. Otherwise, any classification system will not work. And at the same time, evaluate the medium-term results at the time of the third year's recession and the QI quadriceps plot. Study was conducted at Harvard University. It was published in 2011 in the Journal of Children's Orthopedics. This has been approved as a classification of severe classification since then, despite the many complications. We seek the new classification based on our understanding that when compared to the So we're initially disappointed by the knee wide quadriceps cluster because of the bleeding, the wound breakdown, etc. So we decided to perform the 30-day recession in the knee in which the passive flexion was less than 30 degrees and found no contraindication in the surgeon using this. Unfortunately, at surgery, the knee was irreducible with 30-day recession. Obviously, we had to abort the procedure. We could not do the knee wide quadriceps cluster at the same session because the wounds were in different directions. So let's go later in 2 months post-operative and do the knee wide quadriceps cluster. We therefore decided to set the range of passive flexion as the primary criterion for the new grading system. And this is the grading system that has been established, in which we have passive flexion more than 90, this is the grade 1. If it's between 30 and 90, this is grade 2, and if it is less than 30, this is grade 3. As we can see in this very nice, I believe, nice illustration, this is a Leveuf grade 3, because on the X-ray, the joint is dislocated. But as we can see, the one on the left has hyperextension only of 20 degrees and the other one of 40 degrees. But if we try and passively flex the knee, this knee flexes only to 20 degrees. So it is a grade 3 on the new classification. This one can be flexed to 90 degrees even though the hyperextension was more. And so it is a grade 2 on the new classification. And this is a major difference in the treatment protocol that we can apply. We had 11 infants in 21 CDKs. We excluded syndromic and paralytic cases to try and standardize the study. The age of the initial treatment varied from 5 to 300 days, average 83 days, and the follow-up average 41 months. These are the numbers of the patients we have. We can see them on the pie chart. And the number of treatments we used, the most common was the 30-day recession. All grade 1s, well, that does the ones that we could treat, we could flex passively more than 90, were treated with serial casting. All the grade 2s and the one of the grade 3, including the one that we did as a mistake before developing the classification of 30 cutaneous quadriceps recession, 4 out of 5 of the grade 3 had QI quadriceps closed. The results, 4 children were able to walk independently before the age of 20 months. All these that had excellent results were either a grade 1 or grade 2 on the new classification and had been treated by serial casting or percutaneous recession. The only knee that underwent percutaneous recession had a fair outcome, was a grade 3, and opposite decision of the percutaneous recession was wrong because it was based on the previous classification. 3 out of 4 knees that had VY had good results and 1 had a fair result. This is an example of a pick that was a grade 2 on the new classification. Even though on the older definition, because the joint is dislocated, after 5 years there is good congruity of the joint and there is full flexion and relatively good scars compared to the ugly scars of the QI quadriceps plus. This is an example of another patient that was grade 3 on the new classification system because it would not be bent for more than 20 degrees. And the 5-year follow-up, even though the scars are not very nice, but at least the patient can stand upright and can sit with flexion 80 degrees. This girl also had bilateral hip dislocation that was treated, but in a study that was studied 56 CDKs and used the Leveuf classification. He found that 50% of the Leveuf grade 1 needed PY quadriceps cluster. And as far back as that time, His study concluded that there was no direct correlation between the rate of joint displacement and the operative indication. But he so the message is the investigation. We concluded that based on the results of the investigation, based on the standard investigation like the one we developed, was better than the standard investigation based on the technology deviation of the research, which was delivered in 2011, the gold standard investigation. We agree with all previous authors that the reduction of CDK is essential prior to treating any associated pain dislocation or only bone. You cannot treat either when the knee is still in bigger pain. But contrary to the conclusion of Roy and Crawford and many others who said that they were reserved the DY quadriceps plasty only for cases that fail after 30 sessions, we recommended the following protocol. So based on the investigation system of the CDK, grade 1 will be treated by serial crossing, that is the one that can be flexed more than 90 degrees. A grade 2 that can be flexed between 30 and 90. If the child presents in the first month of life, we can do up to 4 serial crossing, and if we achieve flexion more than 90 degrees, he carries on with the serial manipulations. But if we cannot achieve 90 degrees after 4 serial crossing, we have to proceed to a percutaneous recession. If the baby with a grade 2 presents above the age of 1 month, we should proceed to the percutaneous recession immediately. And if he presents with grade 3, we proceed to VY quadriceps plasty from the start as young as 2 or 3 weeks of age. We do not worry about that, and if we cannot flex the knee more than 90 degrees, we do not waste time in serial plasty. Because CDK is a rare condition, the number of patients included in this study and the study design was too small to apply the standard statistical studies, and this was accepted before publication. Idiopathic CDK can be treated successfully because we excluded the syndromic cases, and we have to be very careful with the arthrogryposic patients and do not have the same enthusiasm in treating them as the idiopathic cases. Grade 1 and 2, we can usually expect them to have excellent or good results, while grade 3 may have good results, although wound breakdown and deep infection are common. You tell the parents that for at least 4 weeks, most often the child will go for another change of cast and dressing under anesthesia. Some extensor lag and limitation of flexion is inevitable, and the bulbous knee with marked laxity is common. We usually treat it later on by a supracondylar lateral opening wedge osteotomy to try and tensionize the lag and elongate structures. Like this lady, you have had a bilateral problem with severe CDK, it was grade 3 on the new classification because on the slide, bottom slide on the right, you cannot flex at all or just 5 degrees. She had successful operations with VY quadriceps plasty, but by the age maybe of 4 or 3 or 4, she developed genovulgum. She underwent the osteotomies and the knee was straightened, and she is doing fine now. I think she is now about 10 or 11 years old. Thank you very much.